By default with sparklines, empty cells are effectively ignored. So we can see here on our fruit and sales data with sparklines that where there's an empty cell, on a line chart you get this gap that appears both there on the apples and the pears, and on the column charts you see we just get a big space where there's a effectively a null value, big space there, big space there. Now we can actually ask it to deal with the empty cells differently. With a bar chart, if I select these sparklines here and go to the Sparkline Tools Design Ribbon, over on Edit Data, we have the option for dealing with hidden and empty cells. Now with a column chart, the only option is to leave a gap or to treat them as zero. OK, and you can see then that the bars all slightly change because this value is now not being ignored, it's being treated as a zero value all the way through these options because they're grouped. With a line sparkline, it's treated slightly differently. If we go to Edit Data, Hidden and Empty Cells, and you can see we have an extra option to connect the data points with a line. So then, instead of having a gap, the previous value and the next value are joined together. So we can go Connect Data Points with a Line, and you see they then get joined up. And the same with this one. And that way the line doesn't look like it just ends nowhere. Now with our share values, if there happened to be some missing data for June there, we end up with a gap. But we could do the same thing. Sparkline Tools Design, Edit Data, Hidden Empty Cells, and just tell it to connect the data points with a line. In this same dialog box, also have the option to show data in hidden rows and columns. Because again, by default, if you display a sparkline against some rows or columns of data, and some of those rows or columns are hidden, then they do not feature in the sparkline result, whereas placing a tick here would mean that they would. So at the moment we're looking at connecting the data points with a line, and that way I don't have a gap. Let's add some markers to see how that differs. You see there's no marker at that point there where there's no data, but the line continues anyway to the next marker point. So that's how to deal with effectively empty cells so that your sparkline doesn't look a bit amiss or a bit mad with a big gap in it.